So the first product I'm using to start off the makeup is the Flawless Finish Primer. The primer I have used here provides a smooth base and also it holds the makeup for long. Before this step, I have moisturized my face with a moisturizer that you can use any as per your skin type. Then after priming the skin, it's a 24-hour weightless liquid foundation I'm applying. This foundation gives you medium coverage, but you can obviously build it up as per your requirement. And this foundation provides a natural look and doesn't feel cakey at all. Now I'm using the Flawless Full Cover Concealer to bring forward the high points of my face. Always remember, when you want to highlight with concealer, you need to use 2-3 shade lighter concealer than your actual skin tone. So I'm applying this concealer under the eyes, on the bridge of my nose, chin and on the middle part of the forehead, and then blending it out with the help of the blender. To set the under eye area, I'm using the Sheer Touch Mattifying Loose Powder. This will prevent occurring of crease lines. Also, I'm using it below the jawline to bring that area a little bit forward. So basically, I'm lightly baking and setting the makeup here. And then after dusting off the powder, I'm using a large fluffy brush and I'm spreading a powder all over face to set the rest area of face. And I have a very little amount of powder on the brush. Now to give some dimension to the face, I have done contouring using the Flawless Touch Contour and Highlighter Kit. I have used it on my jawlines, under the neck to make the face look thinner and to chisel the nose and make it sharp. Then for the cheeks, I have used a very subtle blush and it is named as Cheeky Illusion Blush and the shade is Earthy Touch. After that, to set the makeup at place and to make it intact, I have used the Stay the Day Finishing Mist. And while the setting mist is little bit moist, I am then applying the highlighter from the Flawless Touch Contour and Highlighter Kit. By following this technique, you can make highlighter more popping. Though this highlighter is a subtle one and is perfect for this look. And I'm using it for my cheekbones, nose, chin, upper lip and the middle part of the forehead. Here the face makeup is completed and it's time for a lip color. For my lipstick, I'm using the Matte Me As I Am lipstick in the shade Outrage. The shade is very beautiful and it glides on lips like a butter. After that, I'm using a stunning mini brow pencil to carve my brows. And one thing I must say, you have to be very careful while working with this pencil because I have never used such pigmented and smooth brow pencil ever. It glides even before you think. A good and a must try product. Then I have used the same concealer I have used earlier to highlight the face as my eyeshadow base. It's always good if you use a light base for your eyes. It brings out the eyeshadow pigment in a better way. So then, for creating a crease line, I'm using a very little amount of Cheeky Illusion blush on the crease using a fluffy brush. You need to make sure that you are not overdoing it. Just keep it subtle. Then for the lid, I have used the highlighter from the Contour and Highlight Kit and applying it using my finger. You can use a flat brush too. Then comes the exciting part of the look, and that's a kajal. Here I am using It's a Scandal Kajal in the shade Poolside. It's a very beautiful blue-green sort of shade, and I'm using it as both my kajal and liner, creating a wing. For the last step, I have applied the Zoom and Whoosh mascara. Then I have completed my other eye off camera, and here's the final look.